Peter was able to answer this because Peter was different from all the others who did not know Jesus. And this is a point I want to make today. Paul too was able to follow because he was different from those who did not know Jesus. From the moment Paul had his conversion, he was ready to die for Christ. He preached everywhere. He was in prison. He did so much because he now came to realize who Jesus is. And he longed to come to know him. He says all he wanted was to know Jesus and the power of his resurrection. Peter too knew Jesus. Peter had a relationship with Jesus. So all the others who thought Jesus was John the Baptist, was Jeremiah, was one of the prophets, they did not know him because they don't have a relationship with him. But these ones who have a relationship with Jesus knew him. So Peter could say, you are the Christ, the Son of the living God. Today, Jesus is asking you and I, who do you say that I am? Do you have a relationship with him? If you don't have a relationship with Jesus, you cannot know who Jesus is. And I keep saying here, have a relationship with Jesus. You're not just coming to church. It's not just coming, you sit down, they say, pray. You pray, the Lord be with you and also with you. Just by lips. You must have an experience of him, a personal relationship with him. So much that even if you are not in this place, you travel, you are not here, you still long to go to church. You still long to serve the Lord. Not say because you live here in church or you live around the church, you're able to come for morning mass, and then you hear us talk about God every time, we ring the bell, we run to the church. That is not enough. You must have the personal desire to serve God. And I keep saying, if you are not here, would you go to church? If you do not ring the bell one day, will you come to church? We say, don't ring the bell in the morning for people to come to church. Will you come to church? If you have to travel, will you go to church? If you don't have a relationship with Jesus, you can't go to church without the bell. You can't go to church without being asked to go, without following programs. Will you on your own want to stand up and say, I'm going to church? If you have to travel. Some person will say, oh, I didn't go to church because I traveled. You traveled. Where you went to? Is there no church? A good Christian, a good Catholic, if you travel, will first of all look for a church the evening before, the closest church, ask for my closest church before you put up in a hotel anywhere. One of the questions a good Christian asks when he gets to a hotel is there any Catholic church around here? What is the distance? Try to find out where the church is. A good Christian, wherever you go, you try to find out the program of the church around. So in the morning, you leave your hotel room and go attend mass before you come and go for your program. But someone who does not really have a relationship with God does not care. All that person is concerned about is where he's going. Whether he's going to spend 1 week, 1 month there, it's not his business. Then when he comes, he says, sorry, Father, bless me, I couldn't go to church because I traveled. You traveled to where? You didn't go to the bush. Even went to the bush, there are still people who pray in the bush. So that relationship with God is very important wherever you go. That was what Peter had. Because he had that relationship with Christ. So he knew Christ. If you didn't have a relationship with Jesus, you wouldn't know him. That's why he could say, you are the Christ, the Son of the living God. He knew him. Paul knew Christ. Do you know Christ? You have a relationship with him.